In this model, we are going to discuss about the management. Very famous personality, Mary Parker Follett, given a very famous definition about the management. Management is an art of getting things done with and through others. So we plan many of our actions, execute them in a proper way, and then we can achieve our desired results. That is a management. Suppose we are in the hostel or school or playground, wherever, we should plan for our action in the proper way, and that plan should be executed in a systematic manner. Then only we can achieve our desired goal. Suppose we want to go to the tour, we have to plan everything. We should arrange the transport, food, accommodation. So like that, we have to plan everything in yearly. And that plan should be executed in a systematic manner. Then only we can achieve desired goals. So that is the management. And next, we are going to discuss about the 5 M's of management. So the first one is a method. So the manager should know method. Then only who run the business efficiency. So without knowing the method, who does not run the business? And the second M is the material. So material refers the resources. So all the resources should be used in a proper way. That is the use of the management. For example, the water factory means, so the water is the resources. That resources should use the proper way. And the third M is the machinery. So machinery refers to accounting tools. So many accounting tools are there. So those tools should be used in the proper way. So it's a smooth running of business. It help to run the business. And fourth M is the money. So without money, we cannot run any business. And fifth M is the man. So without manpower, we cannot run any of our business. So these are the 5 M's of the management. I repeat again, the first one is the method. The manager should know all the method. And second M is the material. Material is refers the resources. All resources should be used in a proper way. And the third M is the machinery. Machinery refers the management tools. So the tools are accounting, business, law, psychology, statistics, economics, data processing. So using those tools, we can run our business efficiently. And money, so without money, we cannot run any business. And fifth M is the very important M, that is the manpower. So without manpower, we cannot use all remaining 4 M's. This is the 5 M's of the management. So on the next, we are going to discuss about the concept of management. So the concept of management refers all management studies. So the first one, body of knowledge, management tools, separate discipline, specialization, code of conduct. So one by one, we are going to discuss. The first one is the body of knowledge. So the body of knowledge has developed into specialized body of management theory and management philosophy. So if you are study the management philosophy or management theory, it's used like a passport to enter the world. So nowadays, management studies or management literacy growing in all country. If you are studying the management theory or philosophy, we can enter the world used by this passport. And the employment may be the business world or government or private. And the next one, management tools. In the management tools, already we discussed in the 5 M's, you know. So the machinery, so the same tools we are going to use here also. That is the accounting, business law, psychology, statistics, economics, data processing. So suppose we are using these tools in our business, so we can enhance our business in the proper way. And the next one is a separate discipline. So separate discipline means management have separate study, even export management, general management, production management, marketing management, financial management. So like that, so every management has separate discipline from 1951 onwards. So the management, specialized schools of management give you a master degree for the management and administration. And the next one is a specialization. The last class we're studying about the principles of modern management, and the 14 principles are there. The first one is a division of work. According to the principles, so the whole work of the business divided into the small tasks and hand out to the specialized person. So those specialized person should be highly qualified, trained and experienced person. So that is a specialization. So thus we have today increasing the tendency in favor of management by expert or professional. Expert or professional is a specialized person. As a result, we can increase our efficiency of labor and also we can increase our production. So and the next one, code of conduct. So last year already we studied about the social responsibility, the 17th lesson in your plus one book. So social institutions, so any organization should have a social responsibility towards the customers, employee and the public or community. There is a code of conduct. Even nowadays corporation also have a social conscience and awareness. That is a code of conduct. So any institution should have social responsibility towards the customers, employee and the public. Even corporation also have nowadays social conscience and awareness. That is their code of conduct. And the next one, professional association. So it refers the consultant. Many consultants companies are there. So in many countries to promote spread the knowledge of all managers, so and all over the areas to build up the bright public image of a manager professions. So it helped to build up the best image of a manager proportion. So the concept of management refer all management studies. So first one is a body of knowledge. The body of knowledge refers the management theory and philosophy, and second one, management tools. So many tools are there: accounting, business law, psychology, statistics, economics, data processing. Using this we can enhance our business. So and separate discipline, so many discipline in the management, that is a export management, general management, production management, etc. Many are there, and specialized persons are there using the business. And a code of conduct, the corporation or social institution should have a social responsibility, that is a code of conduct. And a professional association, so the consultant company used to spread the knowledge in all over the world to build up the public images. So today class is over. Kindly study, and after hearing this video, kindly read carefully. And again, if you are here this video, you can understand easily. Thank you, students. We will see you on the next class. Thank you.